But yeah, it's so that was just rough.
Maybe a very rough metal for the Ouija. Yeah, just all the fun really coming out of nowhere and just really doing quite well. But we'll see. We'll see how he does against
Rivers. I think this will be interesting to see as well. This will definitely be Father Plum's biggest test. Yes. Against one of the Power 3 of Ontario.
Do you think Father Plum is MLB
then? I don't know. Do you have a favorite My Little Pony pony? A favorite My Little Pony pony?
He's not MLB yet. No, no. It's very sad.
Hey, it's over. Alright, so Riddle's opting for the Joker. Riddle's opting for the Joker. Father Plum, Lucas.
Father Plum trying to get on next year's list.
Yep.
Riddle's list
sounds great. Yeah, very true.
Lots to prove here. Lots to prove. We'll see how that goes.
Riddle starts off really good.
Quick thing, what do you think how Gunn is matchup?
Gunn is going to be extremely...
Stops it midway.
Yeah, Gunn is going to be like super clutch offstage against this in recovery. Basically, if Lucas doesn't tether or air dodge or jump to straight, Gunn can just keep gimping.
Could Gunn also catch his tether?
Yeah, if it doesn't, before he hooks it.
So, is that the reverse of
The drag downs.
Very nice.
And good awareness to know that up smash or down smash would not kill on just continuous combo.
Yeah, actually, I think it wouldn't have even been true at this level. Because if they're not high enough, then they can just shield, but like, the grab is always going to be there.
Exactly.
Because they don't have enough frames to stop that.
Arsene comes out to just show the F smash, extend the range.
Yeah.
And that you can die to that thing at 70, so at 100 you're definitely dead. So Riddle's trapping the ledge. Joker has an insanely good ledge pressure. Gets the initial up throw, up air combo, 21%.
I think a big thing we're seeing from Riddle right now is just that he's a lot better at pressuring Lucas and getting to space really quickly.
Exactly.
And like, of course, that has to do with the different moves.
Yeah.
And Joker is like, I mean, when you think about TMS6, he focused mostly on IDC.
Oh, but he gets spiked.
He focused mostly on IDC and Charizard. Like, the frame down was hard for you to approach him.
Exactly.
Luigi, like, dual frame down's not bad, but, like, same thing here. Like, you just don't have the speed.
It's not necessarily even the frame data that Joker has, because Nair and Dare is actually, like, relatively bad in terms of frame, but just his ground air speed is insane. And his movement just feels so clean. I'm sure you know, and I know as a former Joker player, that his movement just feels very melee.
It is.
Like, it's very... Oh, he's dead. Could have definitely down smash, but maybe up smash does come out slightly faster. Maybe he knew. Yes.
Oh, okay. So
up smash.
Because I've tried laughing at the same combos that work with this. Like, down smash doesn't work at that this time. So like, I guess like in this scenario, it's like
yeah. I'm gonna check something real quick, but I almost
Kyle is checking something right now.
I'm almost certain that up smash is faster for this.
Yeah, like that's doing really good though. I don't know if that back over there, but the forward tilt kind of cancels all that. My forward tilt, sorry.
Wait, what happened? How did that?
I'm actually not completely sure, but just a good read overall.
Lands with down gun. Down gun's actually incredibly good for landing. It's actually, if the person's not shielding, it's actually unpunishable. Actually, I'm almost certain that even if the person is shielding, down gun cannot be punished. They space away from you. Okay. Fares him to follow the chunk. Grabs him right out of the
chunk.
Oh, nice turnaround back here. Okay. Almost got the fair one conversion. Oh, yeah, no, he's keeping in the corner. And the key is that even though Father Plum has the right spacing that he likes, Riddles is just moving around. That's up. Doesn't get the drag down. But even though Father Plum's spacing well, Joker just moves around so much, it's hard to pinpoint where he's gonna be. And a lot of Father Plum's wins has come from his like really good reads of where someone's going to be. And he gets
Yeah, misses the ledge.
But yeah, no, Father Plum is really good at calling out where people are gonna be, which is honestly what you should be doing in this game. You don't hit where people are, you hit where they're gonna be. But Joker's movement is so ambiguous that you don't really know. It's really a 50-50 at that point. Mm-hmm. And if you miss, Joker's just gonna punish you. Yeah. Super hard.
Yeah.
Especially if he has Arsene. You might actually be dead if you make the wrong move.
That'll be a tough one. Tough one for sure. Very clean Joker play coming out. Very clean. Yo, look at this.
Oh!
What's happening here?
Father Plum makes the switch to Lucario.
And I kind of. I don't dare say that this is like a terrible matchup against Joker. But like, when it comes to like those arrows, like, Rose is just pumping out like monsters. Like, it's tough, right? Like, he's jumping a lot. Like, Lucas' aerials were, like, to be honest, like, don't have the best range. Like, it's not like his nearest monster, but, like, it's not Palomir. You know? It's not Palomir.
Also, if, Joker's actually without Arsene doesn't kill until, like, 110, 120. And if you let Lucario get to that point, that's gonna be really bad.
Yeah.
So I kind of understand the switch, but. But Arsene is out, so this is gonna be very pivotal. If Rose can get the kill here with an Arsene timer, this is gonna be huge. Because he denies all that aura. Ooh, gets hit with the aura sphere though. Oh, directionally air dodges.
Oh, I thought he died. He bounced off the stage, but he was able to drift back.
Yeah.
Just a lot of empty hops coming up from Riddles. Lots of empty hops.
So misses the ledge on that up B.
Yeah, unfortunate.
But actually, so back to the rich.
Force
oh
smash.
My god. So, a lot of people don't know this, but Lucario does still have aura when he's at zero if he's a stock behind. Which is called
only when he's behind.
Yeah, if he's a stock behind, he still gets automatic aura. I'm not sure how much you would convert it to percent if someone could. But he doesn't start off the game with zero. Start off the stock with zero aura if he's behind. So that kind of made him a little less volatile in that sense. So his comeback mechanic is still really strong.
But now that he's a stock, three even stocks, like would that aura just like be gone now?
Yes.
Or?
So
after it's like dynamically.
So for example, if he had 69% and he was still behind, it would it would add together. It would be the kind of like behind aura plus the actual percent aura. But now, yeah, he's at 80%. His aura is like, this is a significant amount of aura. I think 150. I think his aura scaling stops at the same time rage stops, if I recall.
Great hit on that.
Oh,
wait,
clings.
Up B into cling.
Yeah.
I didn't even know that was possible.
I didn't know
that
was possible.
Really good
for the
first... I see why Kalos is a good stage for that too, then. Just helps him mix up his recovery.
Which is weird. Oh, starts with F smash and gets two frame
by. What?
Oh yeah, Aegon can't climb for that.
This man's going insane right now.
So, another thing to note is that Lucario's up, he also scales with Aura. So, nice up smash
ball. I'm gonna be using this setup. I'm gonna be using the setup that Claire is on.
Also, yeah, so... What I said earlier was right. So down smash comes out of frame 12, up smash comes out of frame 10.
Okay.
So
two extra frames. It's pretty helpful.
Okay. Oh, tried to drag him down, but I guess he was a little bit too high percentage for that. But keeps really good space on the gun.
Starts in a minute or two. If I called your setup that I'm going to be using you, don't start again.
So we see Kevin in the background there, just abusing his power as usual. very power hungry. But that's okay.
Oh, is that a kill? No, okay.
You know, it's not going to work at that percent.
Ooh, I think it's a 4% in
ledge traps.
How good is this mic?
It's gonna pick up.
Wait, did it pick up?
Looks like
they're. You gotta buy.
You think he's gonna stick the card in?
Maybe. That actually wasn't too bad for him. And if he really does think that Ness has a harder time against Joker, I could see him sticking. Mm-hmm. I don't know, he might switch to another character. Yeah, sticking to Lucario.
The game was kind of close. It was last knock, but I don't know. We'll have to see.
And if I recall, he actually SD'd on his first stock. So had he not SD'd, this match could have gone a little bit different. But Ritter starting off with down throw fair, very standard combo, good combo. Trying to catch him with the charge of Aura Sphere.
Ritter's just shooting it off. Most player might have liked the issue earlier.
See, the issue that I think Podipom has in this matchup is that Joker plays, the way that Joker plays, or I think the way that Joker should play, is similar to the way that Podipom plays, in which it's very, very reactive. But the problem is, Joker can actually aggressively play passive, if that makes sense. Like, he won't attack you, but he'll like run at you, run back at you, and you can't really punish him, because his movement is very clean.
Yeah, I agree.
Can
I go for that 2-frame? Or just catch him with 4 grabs?
Oh, he can't. Oh, that was enough shield stun to actually not be able to get shield grab. Oh! Falls out the shield drop with down smash? That's actually, like mega break right play.
Oh, that's crazy.
I've never seen someone so confident in their down smash that he just.
Like, I've tried that before, but like, it always just hits their shield or they just punish me.
Exactly.
I don't know if that's luck or reaction speed. Could be luck too, but like, either way, like, really nice to go on.
I know. I just hope that doesn't get to Father Pump's mental. Yeah. Hopefully, he can bounce back.
Pump was up during that spot too.
Exactly.
But, Ruto Center Rock Pump,
gets percent
from that really great counter group. Too much lag, too, catches him with a dash attack. The percents are really starting to rank up, but instant.
Gets the cinematic with a side B.
Like, was Lucario either have like an animation while he was flying, or like the game was like basically. Or sorry, Joker, I think. We just sent him up.
I know, yeah, I did see him go out, but it was extremely fast.
It was pretty fast.
Like, the game definitely like let you know that he was dead.
Yeah, that's true.
With that freeze frame. Yeah, now he has 101 aura. Oh, okay, good conversion.
Pump being a bit safer, being able to punish that counter.
Now. He needs to play around this very carefully. Yeah,
the roll on the platform. That's a big thing right now.
And he's gonna get early combos, 50% off.
Is that true?
Yeah. At early percents, you can actually go for up. You can actually go up throw, up air, drag down into re-grab on the platform, but he just went for the safe damage of up air into forward air, which is still 50 damage, but gets the confirm with backside of Aura Sphere to up smash, but doesn't kill yet. Ooh, doesn't kill again with an Aura Sphere, and this is where...
Oh, clips him. The flashes came out too.
Yeah, no. Charges up smash, doesn't quite kill. Okay. That was actually really key that I killed, because that was full Arsene meter. If that didn't kill, that was really bad.
Yeah, but this is last spot.
Yeah, now in the ledge
like,
pressure
starts. Still has a chance to show if he plays this really quickly.
Oh, the bubble? Yeah. So, congratulations to Riddles. For winning UT place. Ball Clash.
At our first Fall Monthly.
Big ups to Father Plum coming in from Guelph.
Father
taking Pump, second.
Coming out of nowhere. Really surprising a lot of us with this Lucas.
Mr. Cold? Oh.
No.
This brand's all done? Oh, okay.